Alrighty, welcome to another edition of Science Sunday, joined by, of course, Aoife Ryle here at the Connecticut Science Center and a couple of your friends. We're in the butterfly encounter.
Yeah, we are in the butterfly encounter. We are actually holding moths right now, okay. Not butterflies.
Interesting. I think anyone would look at these guys, these ladies,
yes,
right?
Yeah.
These are both females,
mm-hmm.
and think that they're probably butterflies, or they wouldn't know any different.
Yeah, they look a lot like butterflies. They're in the same order as well, so there are a lot of similarities, but there are some differences to help you tell the difference between a moth and a butterfly.
Okay.
One of the big ones being when they're usually active. So our butterflies, as you might be able to see, they're flying around us right now. They're diurnal, typically, so they're active during the day. Whereas moths typically are nocturnal. They're out and active at night, right? You might see them around your lights.
Pretty notable difference.
Yeah. So that's why these ladies here are kind of resting, because this is the time they would normally be sleeping.
Sorry to interrupt you.
I know.
Yeah.
They're taking a little nap. Another difference is actually their antennae. So I can pull up some pictures here, but moths have feathered antennae, so you'll see those like beautiful feathers. Whereas the butterfly ones are a little more like sticks. They're like these straight kind of rods with little bulbs at the end. So that's a physical difference between them. And then the last kind of really cool difference is what they emerge from. So butterflies come out of a chrysalis, so it's a hard, kind of smooth structure. But I have in my hand here, this is a cocoon that one of our moths emerged from this morning, actually this one I'm holding. And you can see it's kind of silky on the outside. Butterflies don't have this silk. They don't have the silk cocoon.
Okay.
And this actually in some parts of the world is used as a purse because they're so durable.
Interesting.
Yeah.
All right.
And really fun fact real quick, you're actually holding the world's largest moth.
Oh, tell
the
me more.
Atlas moth. Yeah,
the Atlas moth. The Atlas mm-hmm. moth. All right.
Get up to 12 inches. It's a big moth.
Yeah, and so these are on the smaller side.
Yeah. They're on the smaller side. But yeah, they're still strikingly large, right?
Yeah.
And these beautiful, beautiful patterns on their back there. Might see kind of look like a snake mouth. They're a mimic,
mm-hmm.
so that's a way that they ward off predators.
Interesting.
Yeah.
All right,
yeah.
Good stuff. So obviously we're standing in the butterfly encounter. We've talked about the difference between butterflies and moths, but this is a really cool part of the Science Center. It's an additional cost. You secure your spot here to visit when you're here at the Science Center, mm-hmm. but it's such a cool space.
Yeah, and so we're open right now. You can come and explore. You know, we have dozens of butterflies flying around. We have Atlas moths right now, and you know we're going to keep trying to have those, so you can come and see the difference in person. You can also see our emergence chamber and see butterflies emerging as well. So it is a very cool space. Highly recommend you come check it out.
Climate controlled, tropical-like, it's an alive, growing exhibit.
Yeah, all these plants are real too. There's a lot of life going on in here.
How awesome. All right, Aoife, thank you so much. And of course, we'll see you for another edition of Science Sunday next weekend.